morning. In the previous class, we had studied the basic definitions and the stress. So in this class, we are watching that is the three types of stress. Types of stress. There are three types of stress. First is the tensile or longitudinal stress. Second is the volume stress. Third one is the shearing stress. So depending on the names of the stress, there are three types of stress. First is the tensile or longitudinal stress. So the stress produced by the deforming force acting along the length of a body or rod is called the tensile stress or the longitudinal stress. That is, tensile stress is acting, tensile or longitudinal stress is acting along the length. So that's why it is called the longitudinal stress. Suppose force is applied along the length of the wire or perpendicular to its area of cross sections of the wire. So this produces the elongation in the wire and the length of the wire increases. So therefore, this tensile stress is equals to force divided by area, and this force is acting on the acting along the length of the wire. So that's why there is an elongation produced in the wire. So this type of stress is called the tensile stress, that is the force per unit area. So when the rod, for example, we're taking rod. So when the rod is pushed at the two ends with the equal and opposite forces, so its length decreases. So that's why the restoring force per unit area is called the compressive stress. That means this is also called the tensile stress or the longitudinal stress when the force is applied along the length, means two sides of the length, one side of the length. So there is an elongation produced. That's why it is called the tensile stress. And when the force is applied on the two ends of the equal and opposite forces, the rod is pushed. Deforming forces is applied on the two ends with equal and opposite forces, so there is a length increases, there is a length decreases. So that's why the restoring force per unit area in that type of rod is called the compressive stress. So this is also be the force per unit area. Then second is the volume stress. So volume stress means when the force applied acting perpendicular to the entire surface of the body, we are taking some surface of the body and the force is acting perpendicular to the entire surface, means that type of body, and we are entering the force or applying force on the perpendicular surface area of the body. So it acts normally and uniformly on all over the surface area of the body. So such a stress which produces the change in the size but not the shape. So in that case, there is only change in the size of the object, not the shape. It is called the volume stress. So therefore, volume stress also equal to force per unit area. Means according to name, there is only change in size. Change in size is called the volume force. Here, change in length. So this is called the longitudinal stress. Here change in size, not shape. This is called the volume stress. And third one is the shearing stress. So when the force is applying tangential force, means the force is tangential acting on the surface area. In the volume stress, we are applying force normally on the surface area of the body. And in the third case, shearing stress, we are applying force tangentially on the surface area of the body. So due to this force, this force produces the change in shape of the body without changing its size. So in this case, change in shape, not the size of the body. So that's why this type of force is called the, means the tangential force. Tangential force per unit area. This is called the shearing stress. So this type of stress There are three types of stress: tensile or longitudinal stress, means change in length or increase in length or decrease in length, means force per unit area is called the tensile or longitudinal stress. Here, when the force applied, that is, there is a change in size only, not the shape, is called the volume stress, that is force per unit area. And in the shearing stress, there is a tangential force applied on the surface area of the body. So there is a change in shape. Due to this force, the force produced change in shape, not the size. So this type of stress is called the shearing stress. Then next one is the strain. So the definition of strain is the strain is the measurement of deformation of the body when the two equal and opposite forces are applied on the elastic body. Thus there is a change in the dimension of the body. So the definition of strain is the ratio of change in dimension to the change in dimension of the body to the original dimension. Is called strain. Okay, so this strain is the measure of the deformation of the body when two equal and opposite forces are applied to the elastic body. So there is a change in the dimension of the body. So therefore, the ratio of change in dimension to the original of the body to the original dimension, that means strain is equals to change in dimension to the original dimension. Change in dimension to the original dimension. So, depending on the size and shape and length, there are three types of strain. This strain is the ratio of same, that is change in dimension. If we consider length, then the change in length to the original length. If we consider volume, then change in volume divided by original volume. So this is the ratio of same quantity. So that's why it has, strain has no unit. Strain has no unit. And no unit, that's why no dimension. Okay, strain has no unit and no dimension. So depending on the dimension, there are three types of strain. That is, first one is the longitudinal strain. Second is the volume strain. And third one is the shearing strain. Okay, so there are three types of strain. First is the longitudinal strain, second is the volume strain, and third one is the shearing strain. So first of all, tensile strain. Tensile strain means the strain produced by the tensile deforming forces is called the tensile strain or the longitudinal strain. Here, if we are taking a metal rod . So this is the rod. L is the original length of this rod, and if we apply a deforming force, so this length is increased. This is the small l. Increase in length is the small l, and this is the area of cross section A. So according to definition, the longitudinal strain is nothing but the longitudinal strain is equals to change in length to the original length. So this is called the longitudinal strains. Means after the application of this external force, the length of the rod is increased, or length of the elastic body is increases to small l. So therefore the ratio of this means change in length is the small l and original length is the capital L. So therefore longitudinal strain is equals to small l divided by capital L. So the next one is the second one is the volume strain. So volume strain means the deforming force acting perpendicular to the entire surface of the body produce a volume strain. Means let V be the original volume of volume and delta V be the change in volume. Here second, if V is the original volume and delta V is the change in volume. So therefore according to definition, this volume strain is equals to change in volume to the original volume. So by putting this value, change in volume is the delta V divided by V. So this is the volume stress, means change in volume to the original volume, that means delta V by capital V. So third one is the shearing stress. So to understand the shearing stress means the tangential force per unit area. If we apply a tangential force on the surface area of the body, if there is a relative displacement delta L of the bottom face and the top face of the cube, such relative displacement of the two surfaces is called the shear strain. That means if we are taking cube, and cube has the length capital L, small L. Here the cube has small l, and by applying this force on the tangentially, so there is a new position displaced. Means this is the new position and this is the new position is the delta L. Okay, so original position is the L and change in the position is the delta L. So that's why shearing strain is equals to change in position, that means the change in position, that is the delta L divided by small l. Means relative displacement change, relative displacement delta L and original displacement is the L. So therefore the ratio of delta L by is called the shearing stress, and this is nothing but the tan theta. Here because we are writing tan theta, we know that tan theta is nothing but the opposite upon adjacent. This is nothing but the opposite side upon adjacent side. So this is the opposite side. If we are taking this angle theta, so this is the original L and that is opposite, and this is the adjacent, that is the delta L. So that's why this is nothing but the tan theta. And if the deformation is very small, if this delta L is very small, delta L is very small, so we can write tan theta is less than means is equals to only theta. So this is nothing but the theta. So therefore the shearing stress is strain is nothing but the theta. That is the change in displacement, relative displacement delta L to the length of the cube. Okay, so these are the main three concepts, that is the stress strain completed. So in the next class we are starting original topic, means the real topic of this according to BSc level. So Hooke's law, Poisson's ratio. So we will see in the next class. Thank you.